Hey there, buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsee1 here. I said I could only do one of these this week, but I got a little time for this. We'll do another one. What's on the desk? Got a bat buddy that wants me to specially do this for him. I'll get to that. I have this belt. He said, you know, everybody's got urethane belts. Why don't I just learn how to do a latex belt? It can take up to 2 weeks to do a latex belt. But I'm going to show you today why it's nice to have a latex belt. First off, you don't have to worry about it ripping or anything like that. We know how latex is. Okay? It's great. Want it longer, you're probably even stretch it longer. All you have to do is just attach one of these to a belt. Like say this belt's straight and this belt has a little curve in it, no big deal. Attach it in the middle and bend the belt on the back on both sides when you glue it. And then just simply attach it in the back like you would a regular belt. It's my old dress belt. I bought a new dress belt for myself and I said, I'm gonna use that to make a belt for me. So I'm gonna make this belt today, but black's good, but it gets old. I'm gonna show you how to do a very simple paint job. I'm gonna show you what is so great about latex, besides just the fact it's latex, and you don't have to worry about it smelling or ripping as much. I've been working with latex for 30 years. A lot of these videos, you're gonna see me talk about latex. I just got a lot of experience with it. I love the stuff. It helps you to do some things that other materials can't do. All you need is just any kind of spray paint, unless you're gonna stretch it. I advise starting with black Plasti-Dip, because sometimes latex can oxidize depending on your environment. You put this down first, and you could do this in a spray because we're gonna do a lot of work over top of it. This is really just to seal it in because we're not gonna go black with this. So it's just really a sealer coat just to make sure that it doesn't oxidize over time. You don't want your work getting messed up. You're gonna put all this effort into it, even though it's not a lot of effort. I've got a little silver on my brush and the thinner pulls it off. I don't wash my brushes because I know what my brush is gonna do. I learn to know my brushes and choose my brushes accordingly. And you can always start with a new one if you want. I'm gonna give this a little bit of some dusting like we talked about on the other videos. And if I get a little thing on there, I can get it off or I can spot treat it later on. I see a few things I gotta get rid of. I can spot treat it later on. Depending on what kind of look I'm going for, I might not wanna do too much dusting. I might wanna do a lot more treatment. Now, if you watch the cowl video, the art spirit, it's really about the art spirit. You'll see these techniques are used over and over again. It gives you the time. Another thing you can do is if you get, just go ahead and go over again with Plasti-Dip if you get a little spot or take it off. I could go get some thinner, but I'm gonna do it with that. It's so easy. I'm showing you how easy it is. Give it a feeling of an aged quality. I've got a little bit of a texture on this particular belt that I like to do sometimes. And it helps me to make it look different than everybody else's belt, which I like because, you know, it gets to the point where everybody's using urethane, everybody starts to look the same. But with me, that I could come across as my stuff looking different. I literally have to do it out of necessity. Necessity is the mother of invention. Now this particular one is an irregular. And a lot of times I'll do a treatment on an irregular whenever I have one. I'll just let it go to a bat buddy or whoever can use it. And I'll say, look, it's an irregular, it's not perfect. But it's something to have. Now what I'll do is I'll go real heavy, just a little bit in a few areas. Because if you go heavy in just a few areas, it detracts from any imperfections. And it makes it look like, oh, it's not an imperfection. This is his actual belt. How'd you get Batman to give you his actual belt? That's pretty cool. And he even used it a few times. I got some mummy props. A couple of bracelets that Brendan Fraser wore in The Mummy. He had a bunch of them, and I bought a couple. The ones you could tell the prop department made never were used were pretty cheap. But the one that was all messed up, I had to pay more money for, and that's the one that I use when I costume as Rick O'Connell. So I like to have a feeling that something is part of the actual hero's uniform. There's a couple of inconsistencies that you can start to see are showing up a little bit. And this is why I chose to do this belt in a painted version, because it'll never be good enough to just have it be by itself. So I make it into something else. You could do this too. I mean, eventually I won't even be doing this, right? Because you guys will be doing it. I don't know. Looking towards my future. Now you always have to make a decision. Is it flawed enough that you wanna give it the battle look? That's always a decision you have to make. I think it is, personally. In art school, we always learned As soon as something stands out, you know something's wrong with it. But if you can do just subtle things to your work to where it doesn't stand out, all of a sudden it's not a problem. Look at how that just caught that right there. Now that little problem's not a problem. Starting to catch something over here. Maybe if I can get it to catch just right, then these other little areas won't be what we call flaws anymore. They'll start to be part of the actual hero suit. How did you get a hold of this? So depending on your climate, depending on your techniques, a lot of times you can have little flaws like this. When I get something like that, I don't throw it away. I could treat that, get it back up to snuff, but it's not worth it. Especially for this belt, nobody really cares about cylinder stuff. So I just let it be there. I might even go in and bring attention to that area a little bit. That kind of thing. Now I can keep doing this all day. I'm just gonna shoot through this, make this just a, I hope, just a couple minute video. I add a little bit of gold into it. Everything's not just silver, and everything's not just gold. Sometimes there's like a material that something's made out of and it's showing through the paint job. Sometimes it cuts all the way through and there's a scratch and the material is showing through. So I'll use another color to show, oh, it's more worn in that area where it rubs up against his suit when he's grappling up. Maybe a little bit of the color underneath is coming off. This is real subtle. I'm doing this slow and you might not be able to see it very well in the video. And that's because I want to teach you techniques that you can do so you're not fearful to touch your stuff and mess it up. I want you, if you're not experienced with handling a brush or thinking artistically, to have more confidence. If you watch the Art Spirit video, I spent a long time working on this cowl. And I did that on purpose to show you how careful you can be if you so desire. So you guys can have a good time making your own stuff. Now I can keep on working this, but for the interest of the video, let's just keep it short and just show you, this is what you do, guys, this is what you do. And like I said before, you just simply glue it on a belt. And you've got this piece of latex that you've painted the way you want, attached to a belt that you can use with your suit. And the great thing is, if you don't like it, do it again. Spray it over with Plasti-Dip, always polite. Spray it over with Plasti-Dip again and change it, make it gold, make it yellow. Yellow's hard to work with because you gotta go really thick. And once you go yellow, you better make sure you're using the right kind of paint. Real easy to just turn it into an actual belt. Just so easy like that. But it's different. You look at it again and you say, I still think there's some things that I don't like that much. Another thing I do sometimes is just give it a little bit of sheen. And rub that around a little bit on top of it. Put some of that sheen directly on the brush. Because the most outermost areas are the ones that are gonna catch the most sheen. Now the deeper recessed areas aren't getting as much. And that's gonna show a little bit more subtleties. Another thing it's gonna do is it's gonna rub in your brush strokes a little bit because of the thinners in the paint. And it's gonna make it so your brush strokes, if they were a little heavy-handed in a few areas, get softer. So that's really helpful. That's another thing to think about. And that's about all for today, guys. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsee1.